Now let's talk about the minimum number of teeth on a gear wheel. So this is fairly complex diagram to look at. So the above circles are for a pinion wheel and the bottom circles are for a gear wheel. The outer circle is the addendum circle, then you have the pitch circle, and then you have the base circle. Okay, the pitch circles, this and this, they intersect at a point which is P, that's the pitch point. At pitch point, you have a common tangent. Then you have the centers O1 and O2, which is joined by a line O1 O2, which is passing through the pitch point. Okay, so you have this angle between the common tangent at the pitch point and the tangents at point A and point B. Now, point A is the point which is the point of intersection of the addendum circle of the gear and the base circle of the pinion, and the same thing for point B. So, when you join point A and point B, you get the common tangents at the base circle, which is passing through the pitch point, and this is the common tangent at the pitch point. So the angle between the common tangent at the pitch point and the line joining A and B is alpha. Okay. Now similarly, if you draw O to B a perpendicular to AB and O1A a perpendicular to AB, the angle between O1 O2 and O1A is also alpha. All right. So the velocity ratio, I would say, let us say the number of teeth for pinion is Z1 and the number of teeth for gear is Z2. So the velocity ratio, that is I, this is equal to Z2 by Z1. Okay, so if you want to find out the addendum for the pinion, the addendum for the pinion would be AP into module. Okay, and the addendum for gear would be AG into module. Now this AP and AG, these are merely constants with which we have to multiply the modules to get the respective values of addendum for pinion and for gear. Okay, so these two values are constant values. Okay. So you have your addendum for pinion and the addendum for gear. Now let's look at the triangle O2 PA. I'll draw it over here. This is how the triangle looks like. O2 PA. Okay. And I'll draw a line like this. Okay. This is 90, this is 90, this total angle is alpha. Okay, this total angle is alpha, and if you look at this angle, how much would this be? Okay, let us say this is angle O2PA simply. Okay, so I'll take triangle O2PA and apply the cos rule on this and find out the value for this side. So O2A square is equal to the square of this side, which is O2P, plus the square of this side AP, minus 2 into O2P into AP into cos of this angle in between these two sides. So you will have O2P square plus AP square minus 2 into O2P into AP into cos of angle O2PA. So this is the value. Okay, let us say O2P. Now what is O2P? O2P, this is the pitch circle radius for the gear. So O2P would be module into Z2 upon 2. Okay, and if you look at AP, where is AP? This is AP. AP And if you take triangle APO1, AP is the sine component of O1P. So AP becomes O1P sine alpha. Okay, so this is taken from triangle O1 AP. Okay, so let's put the values. So you will get M Z2 by 2 whole square plus O1P sine alpha whole square minus 2 into M Z2 by 2 into O1P sine alpha into cos of, if you look at this angle, that is, this O2P is basically a vertical line. Okay, so I have not drawn it vertical. So this has to be a vertical line. If I redraw this, this would be vertical. Okay, and this is how you will draw your APO2. So this line, this angle is 90. So this entire angle becomes 90 plus alpha because this small angle is alpha. So this becomes cos of 90 plus alpha. Now let's move forward with this. So you will have your O2P as MZ2 by 2. So your O1P would be MZ1 by 2. Okay. So you will get MZ2 by 2 whole square plus MZ1 by 2 sine alpha whole square minus 2 into MZ2 by 2 into MZ1 by 2 into sine alpha. Now cos 90 plus alpha is minus sine alpha. So this will become plus and you will have sine alpha over here. So when you resolve this entire thing, okay, your O2A will become MZ2 by 2. You can take MZ2 by 2 common. Okay, and this would give you under root 1 plus 1 by I square, where I is the velocity ratio Z2 by Z1, okay, into sine square alpha plus 2 by I into sine square alpha. Okay, so this is O2A. Let's go back to the figure. This line O2A, if you look at O2P plus PC, so you can assume that A and C are very close or nearby points. So I can say O2A is almost equal to O2C, isn't it? So I can say that O2A is equal to O2P plus PC. O2P plus PC. Now I know O2P is your pitch circle radius. So you will have M into Z2 by 2 plus what? Look at PC. PC, that's the addendum. Isn't it? Addendum of the gear. So you will have plus AG into M. So now you can equate this equation and this equation. From these two equations, after equating, because both the values are for O2A, you will get a value for Z2 because that is the minimum number of teeth on gear wheel. Okay, so you will have Z2 is equal to, so when you equate them, you will come to know the answer. That will be 2 into AG, that's the constant with which you have to multiply the module to get the addendum for the gear wheel, upon under root of all this, that's 1 plus 1 by I square into sine square alpha plus 2 by I, that's the velocity ratio, into sine square alpha minus 1. Now minus 1 is not a part of the under root. So this is the formula that you have to remember to calculate the minimum number of teeth for a gear. Okay, now in the next video, we'll carry forward the same analysis to calculate the minimum number of teeth for a pinion wheel.